Hello, welcome in today's video. In today's video for APS 95 pensioners pension hike, Mr. Shyam Rao has emailed to Prime Minister of India to increase the APS 95 pension in budget 2021-22. As all APS 95 pensioners know, after 2 months means in February 2021-22 budget is declaring by Finance Minister. In view of the upcoming budget, APS 95 pensioners are expecting APS 95 pension hike, and as everyone knows, APS 95 National Education Committee is continuing effort to increase the APS 95 pension from Rs. 1000 to Rs. 7500 per month. But till government has not sanctioned the APS 95 pensioners' demand. In view of upcoming budget, Mr. Shyam Rao, National Secretary, APS 95 Pensioners Coordination Committee, Karnataka, has emailed the Prime Minister about the APS 95 pension hike and expressed the situation of APS 95 pensioners and demand for giving budgetary support for APS 95 pensioners in the upcoming budget. For that, he writes a mail to the Prime Minister of India, Mr. Narendra Modi, on 20 December 2020 and expressed the APS 95 pensioners' demand and situation. In today's video, we are going to know about this update of APS 95 pensioners' pensioners' hike. So be with this video till end to know the about latest update of APS 95 pensioners' demand. And if you are not subscribed to this channel yet, please subscribe the channel by hitting the red button below this video and press the bell icon to get the upcoming videos notification. As all EPS 95 pensioners know that EPS 95 National Education Committee has continuing effort to increase the EPS 95 pensioners pension hike. But till government has not sanctioned pensioners hike. In view of upcoming budget, Mr. Shyam Rao, National Secretary, APS 95 Pensioners Coordination Committee, Karnataka, has emailed the Prime Minister about the APS 95 pension hike, and he wrote the APS 95 pensioners situation and demand APS 95 pensioners pension hike in upcoming budget. The email is as here. He write a email to Honorable Prime Minister of India through Dr. Jitendra Singh, Honorable Minister of PMO, the Honorable Finance Minister, the Honorable Ministry of Labour and Employment, Government of India, New Delhi. In subject, he wrote budgetary support for minimum economic security to EPS 95 pensioners regarding. He wrote further, respected sir or madam, the statement of the Honorable Minister of Finance that the forthcoming budget for the year 2021-22 will be like no other in the past is most welcome, and we believe that our pension issue would not be missed in the budget of 2021-22, taking into consideration the following pension, lest we do not continue to suffer for our pension crisis. It is worth inevitable for us that in the context of the ongoing process of annual budget presentation for the financial year 2021-22, it is to submit our grievances that the appeals of EPS 95 pensioners like hike minimum pension with fairness allowance have remained unsettled as at despite the demand put together various memorandum by peaceful protest has taken place hit here to 4 years together. It is unbelievable and very much in knowledge of citizens that the Honorable India government has done commendable, remarkable, progressive work for the well-being of citizens that has eased the livelihood of poor and general category citizens in distribution of LPG supply, rationing of food item by BPL card with the better administrative process, financial support to the farmers, trader, petty businessmen, street vendor, and so many relief as necessitated in form of social welfare measures. Further, the Honorable Government has also come to rescue the unorganized workmen of labor class by providing financial assistance in COVID-19 crisis on the loss of employment and means of livelihood while moving ahead in regular planned development by the revival of economy, construction of highways, connectivity in high scale for fast movement of traffic and goods, and progressive mean in essential sector connected with the mainstream of the life that are visible, but the APS 95 pensioners are unseen and unnoticed of their problem. No bit of financial relief is extended to alleviate their problems. Equality of economic justice for maintenance of basic ULU with livable pension is to be meted out amidst the scenario that prevails in pension system with fairness allowed by regular periodical revisions, medical facility in respect of government pensioners and multiple pensions enjoyed by others for short spells of public services. The issue connected to the pension of EPS 1995 pensioners that deserve utmost serious attention with the concerns of humanity stand to solve with political wish by the honorable government. Sensing the bad situation and unspeakable suffering with dependency on others at the mercy the pensioners are undergoing in present nuclear family set up with a meager range of pension in between less than rupees 1000 and about 3000 that does not meet the cost of any basic need of livelihood. The pension is providing to serve the purpose of providing economic security of life ensured with human dignity, which has been defeated by the Employers Pension Scheme 1995. It shall be a livable pension in fair quantum that meet basic need of life and the cost of medical facility. What is the provide now unbelievable pension under the Employee Pension Scheme 1995? The service of EPS 95 pensioners made with tireless toiling in heydays of life with day and night shift in minor and major industries, cooperation, ports public and private sector owned by central and state government, transport, textile industries, gold mine, steel plant, cement factories, gold mine, etc. and innumerable cottage industries has contributed for the growth of nation visible to all citizens what is looked today. But their plight of livelihood in retirement has been worsened with economic insecurity getting unnoticed by all successive governments that came into power since the inception of the pension scheme. Primarily, farmer worker of either organized or unorganized class being contributed for national economy. Besides, unignorable strength of population have equally important by their dedicated service to hold the nation in high esteem who are essential to be protected of social economic security with human dignity by ensuring constitutional right of citizen and non-violating of human rights as well. But they are made with very much unprivileged, keeping them on different footing is quite to contrast to government pensioners. The Article 14, 21 and such other of the Indian Constitution that are protect the security of life of citizens and human rights. First human right is right to food and health. Second human right is right to an adequate standard of life. Third is right to social security. That is all not to be violated have stood irrelevant to the present leveled situation of the EPS 95 pensioners devaluated of their service who have been crying for justice for years or decades together against the onslaught of meagre pension provided without fairness allowance kept unrevised for 20 years. It vividly speaks on denial of citizen right to live and economic justice and violation of human rights, which is already brought to the kind knowledge of National Human Rights Commission New Delhi for violation of human rights caused by migration. The Honorable Government may kindly solve this genuine issue by making necessary changes in the pension scheme, the scope of the which is very much available in Constitution and better management of pension fund that forms the financial capital, its investment benefiting growing time to time. What matters to the Employee Provident Fund Organization New Delhi in a present pension scheme is inconsistent to the democratic principle. The highest judiciary has upheld with ascertained and affirmation what the EPS pensioners have been demanding for the economic security of life, disagreeing the stand to taken on the conditions of the pension scheme. In the light of the all these developments and understanding the problem of financial insecurity of pensioners under EPS 1995, some honorable members of parliament, members of legislative state assemblies and chief minister of state have also recommended to your honorable government for enhancing of minimum pension with fairness allowance to their letter supporting the demand of pensioners with the concern of humanity. Whatever, if we happen to receive the benefit of pension by its hike and DA, it is spent for needs of livelihood that yield tax to the government, not going to turn into black money. It is the voice of all EPS 95 pensioners coupled with spouses accounting in crores scattered all over the country. Majority of them are poor and very poor citizens doing menial jobs to eke out of their livelihood, unsupportive of their children, being in search of job under COVID-19 pandemic crisis. Kindly let these pensioners be relieved of distress and disgrace in their livelihood here, securing them minimum economic security by the honorable government. On the basis of committee report, logically with the present valuation of average minimum cost of the life of a couple across the nation, that comes about the 10,000 in order that they live a happy and normal life. By giving precedence to livelihood and health of the citizen with a focus in annual budget for the year 2021-22 as assured by the Honorable Finance Minister. With high regard, sincerely yours, Shyam Rao, National Secretary, EPS 1995 Pensioners Coordination Committee, Bidar, Karnataka. For EPS 1995 Pensioners Pension Hike, Shyam Rao, National Secretary, EPS 95 Pensioners Coordination Committee has wrote an email to Prime Minister of India to increase the EPS 1995 Pensioners Pension in upcoming budget. So this is the latest update of EPS 1995 Pensioners demand about the pension hike. If you like the information given in this video, please like this video and if you are not subscribed to this channel till, please subscribe this channel by hitting the red button below this video and press the bell icon to get the upcoming videos notification. अगर आप शेयर मार्केट में इन्वेस्ट करना चाहते हैं तो इसके लिए आपको एक ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट की जरूरत पड़ती है। ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट ओपन करने के लिए वीडियो के डिस्क्रिप्शन में मैंने आपके लिए एक लिंक देके रखा है। उस लिंक पर क्लिक करके अगर आप ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट ओपन करते हैं तो उस ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट ओपनिंग के लिए आपको कोई भी चार्जेस देने की जरूरत नहीं है, साथ में कोई भी एनुअल फी देने की जरूरत नहीं है। और जब भी आप इक्विटी में शेयर खरीदेंगे या फिर बेचेंगे तो उसके ऊपर आपको कोई भी ब्रोकरेज देने की जरूरत नहीं है। अगर मान लीजिए आपने 100 रुपए का कोई शेयर खरीदा और उसे 150 रुपए में बेच दिया तो जो 50 रुपए का फायदा होगा तो वो सीधे आपकी जेब में जाएगा। इसके ऊपर जो है वो आपको कोई भी ब्रोकरेज चार्जेस देने की जरूरत नहीं है, कोई भी यहाँ पर आपको चार्जेस नहीं है। तो इसके लिए अगर आप अकाउंट ओपन करना चाहते हैं तो वीडियो के डिस्क्रिप्शन में मैंने एक लिंक दिया हुआ है, तो उस लिंक पर क्लिक करके आप घर बैठे ऑनलाइन एक डीमैट अकाउंट ओपन कर सकते हैं। तो चलिए अभी वीडियो में आगे बढ़ते हैं। इस वीडियो को देखने के लिए आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। अगर आपको कोई सवाल है या फिर कोई कॉमेंट है तो आप इस वीडियो के नीचे जो कॉमेंट बॉक्स है वहाँ पे कर सकते हैं। और साथ में दोस्तों, अगर आप मेरे चैनल पे पहली बार विजिट करें तो मेरे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कीजिए और जो उसके बाद बेल का आइकॉन आएगा उसे भी आप प्रेस कर दीजिए ताकि मेरे जो आने वाले वीडियोज है वो सबसे पहले आपको देखने को मिल सके।